I wasn't born in Akron. I was born up upstate New York on the Niagara River. And my dad worked for Goodyear. That's why the whole family moved to Akron. For a while, they transferred us over to Japan. And so I spent a lot of my childhood there, too. So I kind of a rootless traveling person is what I am. And kind of trained early on for that. I sing a lot of songs about it. And so having four older brothers and two older sisters, and one of those sisters was an art teacher here in Cleveland for a while. Now she lives in Georgia. She's a very successful painter, visual artist, and a huge inspiration to me too. Follow my own thing. She had, you know, that's a lot of records, that's a lot of vinyl to dig through. And as you see, I travel with quite a bit of vinyl myself. I do not recommend it. It's hot in that car. But if you have a record player, I got the newfangled versions of the albums as well. But you know, looks like there's like two or three record stores just on this street alone. At least two I saw. Do you own a record store?
Yeah.
There we go. Representing. My sister, so the albums that I would pick through there, of my older brothers and sisters, extended and covered a lot of bases. And my sister, she had this one album that had a bunch of little colorful teddy bears all lined up in a circle on it. And I put that album on, and when you're a youngster, you don't care about the movement or the cult or whatever behind any band. You just put a record on, and if it makes you shake your ass, you keep going with it. And this record had a rock and roll band on one side playing a live show, and on the other side had some guys playing acoustic guitars and singing what, you know, turned out to be classic American folk songs. And this is one of the ones I learned from that album. And well, I've kind of made it my own tune now. Lulu, my Lulu, won't you come in and open the door? been all around this world.